We are going to explain the default snippet used for the horizontal situation indicator. This gauge is a very complex gauge with many moving parts, but you will be amazed how simple it is to configure. We need to be in config mode, with the HSI selected, before we can view the default HSI snippet. The inner layer contains the main central background and needs to rotate. The nav OBS1 variable contains the value of the nav course set on the nav1 radio. This nav course minus the current heading will rotate the layer to the correct angle, so we use the variable nav OBS1 less heading. The compass layer needs to rotate to reflect the aircraft's current heading, so the variable to use is plane heading degrees gyro, and again, a gauge action of rotate. The to flag needs to do two things. Rotate with the inner layer so everything is positioned correctly, and be visible when applicable. So config 0 is set the same as the inner layer for rotation. Config 1 is configured for visibility using the variable HSITF flags. This variable is 1, when the to flag should appear, and 2, when the from flag should appear. So we use the action of on, but has flag, would also be valid. A custom value of 1 and a gauge action of visibility. The from flag is the same as the to flag, but with a custom value of 2. The arrow layer is the fixed top and bottom parts of the arrow, and need to rotate in sync with the inner layer, so is configured the same as the inner layer. The deviation layer is the center part of the arrow, and moves left and right, as well as needing to rotate in sync with the inner layer. Therefore, config 0 is configured as per the inner layer for rotation. Config 1 may look complicated, but it's really just simple maths. Each of the deviation markings are spaced 11 pixels apart. There are 5 deviation markings either side of the central marking, which means the deviation layer's maximum position is 5 by 11 pixels, which is 55 pixels from its starting central position. The variable nav CDI1 contains the value of the CDI needle deflection, which is up to plus or minus 127. Plus values move it to the right and negative values move it to the left. We need to convert the nav CDI1 value to how many pixels to move the deflection layer. The maximum CDI needle deflection is plus or minus 127, and our deviation layer's maximum position is plus or minus 55 pixels, or in other words, when the CDI needle deflection is at 127, we need the deviation layer to have moved 55 pixels. Therefore, 55 pixels divided by 127 gives us a CDI needle deflection to pixels ratio of 0.43307086614173. By multiplying the ratio with the value of the nav CDI1 variable, the deflection layer will move left or right accurately using a gauge action of move x, which moves layers left or right, whilst move y moves layers up and down. The nav flag has a config relating to visibility. The nav code's 1 variable contains bit information about the signal being received by the nav1 radio. When bit 4 of the nav code's 1 variable is 1, it indicates that a nav signal is not available. Bit 4 is equivalent to the decimal value of 8, so we use a custom value of 8 and a gauge action of visibility. The action is not the usual, has flag, but is, has flag 0 is 1. It operates as per has flag, which looks for certain bits containing 1, but also it will result in the nav flag being visible, if the nav code's 1 variable value is 0. This happens when there is no power going to the gauge. The heading flag appears when the aircraft's panel has no electrical power, so we use the variable partial panel electrical, which becomes 1 when the panel has no power. The heading layer needs to rotate to indicate the desired autopilot heading. However, the compass layer is also rotating based on the aircraft's current heading. Therefore, simply using the standard variable of autopilot heading lock dir would result in the heading indicator positioned incorrectly. This variable needs the current aircraft heading subtracted from it, so we use autopilot heading lock dir less heading to get the correct rotation. The glide slope layer has indicators on both sides of the gauge that move up and down and need to be hidden if the nav signal is not a localizer. In a similar fashion to the deviation layer, the glide slope markings are positioned 29 pixels apart, with two marks either side of the center marking. This gives 2 by 29 pixels as the maximum glide slope position, which result in a maximum move of 58 pixels, up or down from the center starting position. The nav GSI1 variable contains a value indicating the glide slope needle deflection. Its maximum value is plus or minus 119, where plus values move it up, and negative values move it down. Therefore, the glide slope deflection to pixel ratio is 58 divided by 119, which is 0.487394957983193. In other words, when the glide slope deflection is at its maximum value of 119, we need the glide slope layer to have moved upwards to its maximum position of 58 pixels from its starting position. Therefore, 119 by 0.487394957983193 equals 58 pixels. Config 1 uses the nav GS flag 1 variable to determine if the glide slope layer should be visible. The variable is 1 when it should be visible, so we use an action of on, a custom value of 1 and a gauge action of visibility. This concludes our tutorial. I hope you found it useful.